Welcome, I'm Aliki. I'm here to help you upgrade your energy. In this video, I'm going to talk about how to move your energy into your heart, into your core, and move forward with happiness and with love. I will explain what your energy is, how it moves, how it works, how it can move into your heart and your core, and how do you move forward? How do you truly apply this in your life and move into this so that you move out of the fogginess of your mind and truly become heart-centered? This is part one, where I will explain how it works and what the different things that I refer to are. And in part two, I will take you through the whole process. From the beginning, I will guide you through it step by step as a guided meditation, because I believe that it's powerful for you to have these two separately, so that in one video I explain what it is so that you understand it, and in the second video I take you through the process and we go through this together. So let's get started. If you haven't subscribed yet, subscribe. Also remember to like. It helps my channel grow and for me to get my message across to more and more people, and I really appreciate you being here, so thank you. Now, when I say move your energy into your heart, into your core, you could say, what is my energy? We all know that our bodies are made up of energy, that everything around us is energy. The ground we walk on, the air we breathe, our words have energy, our thoughts have energy. Everything that is physical is made up of energy, but that's not all it is. Everything that is an idea also has energy. Your thoughts, your feelings, absolutely everything is made up of energy. So when we talk about energy, move your energy into your heart, into your core, your energy is all that you have expressed, all that you have thought of, all that you have said, all that you have done, all the places you have been have your energy. Energy moves, energy flows. Energy is not static. We may feel even that sometimes we're stuck, but that even has motion. Even that is your energy moving, and even that has an effect on the way you feel. Different thoughts, different ways that we think have different frequencies, different vibrations. And if you become aware of this, you can see that if you're feeling very happy, you feel this expansive energy. If you're feeling sad, if you're feeling pain, if you're feeling grief, you feel very heavy. You feel stuck. You feel motionless in your life, and that it's very, very hard for you to move forward, to get things done, to get out of bed in the morning. Everything is heavier. Well, when you're excited, when you're in love, everything is just flowing. It's very easy to achieve things. You see things with a positive mindset, and things actually move in a beautiful flow. But when you suddenly start to think of other things, you move into a different type of mindset, everything starts to change. And this is why we say when it rains, it pours. We start to see one thing happening after the other. And we move into ourselves feeling like we're sinking. Your thoughts and your feelings are deeply interconnected. The way that you are thinking affects the way that you are feeling, and the way you are feeling affects the way that you're thinking. If you're feeling down, it's very, very hard for you to think positive thoughts and to be positive, because you're down, your energy is down. You are feeling heavy. Heavy energy means low vibrational energy, low frequency energy. The more that you feel happy, it's very easy to have a positive mindset, positive way of thinking, and to feel expansive, to feel that you're in the flow of things, to feel that you can achieve anything and do anything. Now, all this has different frequencies, and all this has different levels. Your natural state of being is you being in very high frequency, very high vibrational energy. Now, this is in your heart. This is in your core. the more and more you are mind-centered. And mind-centered does not mean using your mind. It means your energy being mainly here in your mind, where you are thinking of everything, where you are trying to understand, where you are trying to use your mind to see the world, to understand the world. Then it is much heavier. It is much more difficult for you to see with clarity because your mind has a limited amount of knowledge, a limited amount of information. And no, I'm not calling your mind limited. It is in your heart that your knowledge, that your wisdom is infinite. So yes, infinite knowledge is within you. Infinite energy is within you, but it's not in your mind. Your mind has only what you have learned, what you have picked up along the way as you lived your life, as you experienced things. And yes, some of this can be distorted, some of this can be unclear. Everything has been stored in your subconscious. Every place you've been, everything you've seen, every word you've said, everything that has been said to you, it's all been recorded. It is all in your subconscious. It's all there. But consciously, you remember a limited amount. Now, your subconscious affects the way that you think. It affects the way that you feel because it has a set belief system. And this set belief system, you may consciously think completely different things, but your set belief system is what triggers your thoughts, what triggers your feelings, what affects the way that you move forward in your life. Now, this cannot just suddenly be erased. You can't say, I'm going to take my subconscious and clear all the energy of my subconscious and move forward a new person. The way to do this is by moving into a different center, by moving and becoming heart-centered. And this is a very powerful shift. Now, this shift doesn't happen in one time. You don't say, now I've moved my energy into my heart, I'm heart-centered, that's it, I'm set, everything's new, I'm no longer affected by my subconscious. That's not how it works. Energy does not work the way that we would work in our everyday lives. If I'm walking along the street and the road I'm on, the path I've taken, diverges, it makes a fork in the road where I could go one way or I could go the other. There I choose, and I choose this path or that path, this way or that way, and then I keep going. It's not that I can suddenly make a choice along the way that, oh, I'm now on the other road. You have to keep going, or you either need to turn back and then take the other way. Energetically, things work very, very differently. You're moving along, you're on your path, and you make a choice every moment. Every moment you can choose, am I in my mind or am I in my heart? Am I using the information that I picked up along the way, or am I going into a place of limitless energy, of powerful, clear thinking, moving into love, moving into happiness, have all the knowledge, all the wisdom that exists? Yes, you tap into all the knowledge, all the wisdom that exists, and you move forward with this. But you need to choose this every moment. It is a choice that you can make any moment, but that you need to choose every moment. And the more you practice this, the more you upgrade your energy, the more you upgrade and move into higher frequency, higher vibrational energy. But it's very natural that you will be affected by the outside world and that you will keep falling into the other path until you steady your path and it becomes so natural. You strengthen your energy so much. You've moved so deeply into your core. You've become so high frequency, so high vibrational that your energy is truly expansive. And this is who you are. You've moved fully into your natural state of being. Until you do it fully, then you will keep moving to the other path and you need to keep choosing it. So let's take a step back. When I say your energy, I mean all your energy throughout time, before time, between time, after time, everything. Everything you've thought, everything you've felt, everything you've seen, everything you've experienced. And I know that with your mind, you cannot remember, you cannot tap into all these places that you've been, everything you've said, everything you've experienced, and that's completely natural. But your heart knows. Deep within you, it's all there. And all you need to do is have the intention of feeling your energy in all of existence. And then pulling it in. Now, what is your heart? What is your core? Let's start with the heart. Your heart truly is the miracle of you. The very first cell that formed of you, of your being, is your heart cell. The very first cell that forms of all of us is a cell from our heart. And as your heart forms, slowly, slowly, you form. You form as an embryo, you form as a body. And your body contains so much energy, so much connection to all your being from within. It connects you to the most powerful, beautiful flow, to the creation of who you are, the creation of you, your first existence, your first being here. And yes, you are here through the beating of your heart. Your heart is the most powerful organ of your body. It is not the energy of your mind. Your mind has a certain amount of energy. Your heart has a much, much greater amount of energy. And deep within your heart is the core of who you are. The core is made up of the most beautiful energy that exists, creative energy, infinite energy. It has all the purest forms of you. It has the energy of you that has been untouched by your experience, untouched by all that you have said and done. It is pure. It has all your knowledge. It has all your wisdom. It has all your love. It has all your happiness, but without having any of the heaviness, without any sadness, any pain, any suffering, guilt or shame. All that is heavy is not in your heart. Your heart is untouched. It is divine. This is why it is so important to move all your energy into your core, because this is a place of purity, of clarity, of empowerment. The deeper within your heart, the deeper within your core you go, the more expansive your energy becomes, the more high frequency, the more high vibrational. And this is limitless. This is infinite. So it's not that, oh, I moved into my heart, I moved into my core, that's it, this is me, now I can move forward. You can go deeper within you. You can become more and more expansive. You can experience more happiness, more love. And this is you upgrading your energy again and again and again. When I produce the second video, which will be me guiding you through moving your energy into your heart and into your core, the more you do this, it has no end. You can keep moving forward with this. You can keep going to a higher level and reaching more and more happiness, more and more love, more and more expansiveness, more and more excitement to be here. You move into truly being happy to be here, truly wanting to be here, and moving into all that you are fully. It is you moving into your natural state of being, into the truth of who you are, who you truly are, not the information you've picked up along the way, not who you've come to believe that you are because of what others see in you, to believe what you are because of what you've experienced, of what's been happening to you up to now. You can move out of this any moment, in every moment, by moving into the truth within you. And that doesn't mean you moving into the world within you and escaping from the world here. You move into all that you are within you in order to move into what you truly are here, now, to be all the best of you, to experience the best of you, to express the best of you in everything you say, in everything you do, in everyone you smile at, in everyone you speak to. Everything you create becomes a beautiful expression of that which is within you, of the most beautiful you that you are, the magnificent you. Your core is energy moving in the most beautiful dance of creation. This energy moves both inwards and outwards. It moves in all directions simultaneously. Now, this motion is not something you can achieve with your mind. If I say move in all directions simultaneously, your mind can't understand this. It's just too much for it to think. Your mind thinks in a way of motion, moving from here to there. And for me to get from here to there, I need to move ahead, or I need to go in some sort of fashion. You can't just appear there. And if you appear there, again, there's motion involved. Now, when I say move your energy in all directions simultaneously, the only way you can achieve this is by doing it with your heart. The only way to move into your heart is by moving with your heart. And the only way to move in the way that your heart moves is to do it with your heart. Your mind cannot do this. So in order to do this, you need to have moved into your heart. And the more you move into your heart, the easier this flows. Have the intention of moving your energy into your heart. Have the intention of allowing it to just move the way it moves. Move it in all directions simultaneously. If I say do this, you cannot do this because you'll say, how is this? But if I say allow your energy to move in all directions simultaneously, see your energy moving in all directions simultaneously, then you can see it. You can feel this beautiful star, the beautiful sun, the beautiful energy that is within you, divine light, divine power, infinite energy, beauty, love, happiness, knowledge, wisdom, in beautiful harmony, in beautiful balance, moving in a dance of creation. This is power. This is true power, infinite, endless power that can achieve anything, that can do anything, be anywhere, do all that you have dreamed, move you into your most beautiful dreams. And the deeper within this energy you go, the more inspired you are. You know how to move forward because it's like tapping into all the knowledge, all the wisdom in existence that has ever existed, that will ever exist. It's your dreams truly coming true, because the more you connect to you and you stand in your power and standing, let's talk about standing. When I say stand in your power, what does this mean? Do you literally need to stand up here in the physical? It has to do with you standing in your power, feeling ground within you, in your heart, in your core is all. So you can feel the ground under your feet. It's not just that you imagine some sort of ground that you like being on under your feet. There is a specific ground that you are most powerful on. It could be made up of pure light. It could be sand. It could be water. And you could say, how could water be ground? Because it's energy. It's made up of energy. It could be diamond light. It could be rock. It could be anything that exists. It is ground that you can truly feel powerful standing on. And yes, you can use your imagination to see it, to feel it. Because what your imagination truly is the eyes of your heart. It is you feeling where it is you are standing, and you standing strong, feeling all that you are within you, moving deeper and deeper within you, and coming more and more out into the physical, affecting every cell of your body, every fiber of your existence, all that you are made up of, all that you are, all that you've ever been, and all that you will ever be. All this is one, because the energy inside you is unaffected by time, is unaffected by space. It is one big embrace. So when you say, if I am here and someone else is there, can I feel their energy? It's beyond time and space, so of course you can. If you say, how is it that I suddenly feel what I felt in the past, that I suddenly see clearly things that happened to me in the past, because this energy is unaffected by time, by space. You can see things that are to come, see things that have happened, see things that are happening now, because this energy is infinite. It is all embracing, all encompassing. It moves in all, it moves all, it makes up all, it is all. And that is how all is one. That is how one is all. It is deep within you, it is deep within me, it is deep within the ground you are standing on, the air you are breathing, the water you are drinking. It is deep within everyone around you, everything around you. It is the core that makes up all. And this is energy. And energy moves in everything and everyone. The more you understand it, the more you feel it, the more you choose to be in your heart, to be in your core, to not have your mind as its center. Your mind is a tool. It is not the center of your being. It is not your true state of being. You have a mind for you to use it, but not to be guided by being mind-centered. Your mind cannot handle that amount of power, that amount of energy. It is limited. So when you move into your heart, you move into your limitless energy. You move into all that you are. And you have clarity. You can look at your choices in front of you and know. You just know. You are inspired. You have that inner knowing of which way to go. And you can keep choosing. You believe in you more and more because you see everything in your life happening. You see the beauty appearing. You see the flow. You see that even if things seem to be going wrong, that they are taking you where you need to go. You believe in life. You believe in all. You know that it is all here for you. And you keep telling yourself, it is all here for me. It is all moving me forward into my happiness, into my love, into my most beautiful dreams. I believe in life. I believe in me. Thank you so much for watching. If you want to watch more videos like this, subscribe and like.